MrBubble.
Come on in, Yivvits. It's open.
I'm here.
And how are you, man?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm ready to do a podcast. I'm ready. Yeah. What do you think?
Podcast. What did you do in here?
Yes.
Wow. Everything's pink.
Well, I did do a few changes. Did a few changes. What can I say?
A pink, though?
Yeah. Well, it fit. It just looks good. I just did some changes. Yeah. I got some new equipment.
I like the new glass barrier between the recording stuff and the sound room there.
That's right.
Very nice.
Very professional.
Very nice. New mixer.
Yep. Thank you.
Ah.
Yeah, it's got a big power.
It's got an extra channel.
Yeah. I had to get a new power supply for it, but it's good. It's a good mixer.
Oh, your power's terrible here.
I know. Anyway.
Oh, what's that? New speakers, too.
Yep. Those are. I imported those right from England. They're BMWs.
Holy
excellent.
Crap.
Excellent speakers.
Are those. Are they made by, like, the BMW people?
B&W.
Oh, B&W?
No, these ones are what? Used to, like. These are ones that are used to, like, mix Abbey Road and stuff. This is good. Good stuff.
And we're using them.
Of course. All the residuals. We're doing good.
Hey, did you by any chance get your check from Sony?
Not from Sony. Did you get yours?
Yeah, I did.
Oh!
I got to call Smed and ask him why he didn't get yours.
Well, I got to call him tomorrow. I'll ask him. Yeah, okay.
They're still paying for, are they doing two subscriptions for you?
Yeah, well, they're crediting.
Yeah.
I mean, I had to pay because that way on the air I can say I'm paying, but then they credit it back. You pay because then you can say with a straight face, yes, I'm paying.
Right.
But then they give a credit back, and you get credit back. So
yeah.
That's all that is, yeah. All
right. Well, maybe that's Kurt right there.
That
Kurt?
Could be.
Is that Kurt?
No, it looked like someone else. Chris Kyle. So
oh,
I'm going to put him on hold.
Yeah, how did he like the bit last week?
Oh, he loved it. Yeah, he loved it.
It was good. He wasn't too upset with you or anything.
No, we played darts.
Yeah, I did talk to Kurt, and he mentioned that he's really enjoying what we're doing and everything. And
Thunderheart's a good guy.
Yeah.
I like it. So, I mean, it's cool. It's working out good.
Yeah, it is working out good for us.
High five. Yeah.
Nobody knows.
So, and because the studio, I did get someone asked me in town from the Chamber of Commerce. They want to bring some businesses by here like for a tour on Friday again.
Oh.
Do you have any time on Friday for that?
Friday... I could maybe fit that in.
Are you going to your stylist or what?
Thanks.
Well, what?
No, yeah, I think so. Yeah, what time?
Well, it depends. It's up to us. It's up to us. It's not up to them.
All right.
So, 10 in the morning? Or is that too early?
10? Are you kidding?
I'm still in my bathroom.
2.
2 in the afternoon.
2 p.m.
That would be after lunch.
So?
That's fine.
That's up to us.
That's good. I know. I'm normally napping, but I could do that.
I think you can handle it.
Should we poop out another podcast here?
Another one.
I know, 41.
I mean, at least like the payments keep coming from Toro and stuff.
Hunts, yeah. Hunts. Let's get going. We just got to do it.
Okay. All right.
What do we got? Let's go with the checklist.
Let me get this.
I'm going to delete the Hello Kitty podcast workspace.
You better delete that.
I know.
There's not much room in that Apple.
I know.
Hold on. I'll get the power conditioning right here.
All right.
Get
that started, please.
I don't understand why you can't get better power here. It's ridiculous.
Well, it's complicated.
But there's a nuclear plant in town. Come on.
I know.
Can you hit the mixer there?
Yep. Turn on the new mixer.
Right.
It's awesome.
That looks like a really cool mixer, dude.
Yep.
That's really cool.
Good mixer.
Is it going to make things quicker?
Quicker, easier, more seductive, yes.
Oh, good.
It's like just like the Force. The dark side of the Force.
All right, we got that.
Well,
is it booted?
I think we're ready to go.
Okay.
Just need to turn on the microphones. Right. We're set.
Let me get this microphone here.
Yep.
What?
What?
Which way?
The switch is towards you if it's on.
Uh-oh.
What?
Nothing.
Welcome to episode 41 of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and MrBubble. Today is Wednesday, May 10th, and even though we have no callers, no trivia, no movie scripts, no music, no whatever, I'm MrBubble.
You don't have Yivvits either.
Oh,
get it? See, it's a joke.
I wish there were no Yivvits. Oh, I don't mean that, dude. But sometime...
No? What?
Yivvits, if I got hit by a... turbo laser or something, would you ever do a podcast without me?
Oh, I'd probably just call a Dak or Obi-Van or Corvin or somebody.
Yeah.
I'm sure they'd all be willing
to
play.
Come on, if you got killed by by Trandoshan or something,
yeah,
I would probably go on with, yeah, me and Iskra would.
You'd feel bad for a couple minutes.
Feel
real broken up for at least a day.
I'd give you 2 minutes, yeah.
Okay. 2 minutes of silence?
If that did happen, though, buddy, could I have, like, your jetpack?
I don't have a jetpack.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's right. Only I have one. All right. Between the two of us. Well, what are we talking about?
You and your jetpack. We're talking about what?
All right. We're talking about Star Wars Galaxies. You and I are friends. You're Yivvits. Mm-hmm. I'm MrBubble.
Yeah.
We're still friends.
Yeah.
We play this game called Star Wars Galaxies.
Yeah.
Which you buy in stores. $20.
You still buy it?
You install it on your machine. You pay them $15 a month for the pleasure.
You pay $15 a month for the pleasure.
It's a persistent... That's not a bad price for pleasure. $15 a month is a deal.
That's pretty cheap.
Yeah, it is.
And install it. Get you back on track.
Right.
Install
back
it.
Back on the rails. Yeah, here we go, on the rails. Climb up the old mountain, the roller coaster.
Getting over the introduction here.
Right. I just must make it climb top. You buy in the store, you install it, you pay them $15 a month because it's a persistent universe.
Yes.
You have a house if you want.
It's persistent.
And when you quit the game for the night and go to sleep.
Your little character does things while you're not there.
Oh. The little
he has a night job.
Little elves come out and fix the shoes.
Oh, that's true. You have those too?
Oh, yeah, my shoes are always... my dad's a cobbler and he always wondered... No.
Well, my dad's not a cobbler, but I have those elves in my house too.
Okay. Anyway.
Yeah.
It's what it is. And it's fun. It's a fun game. We love to play it. We talk about what we did the previous week.
Yeah,
we do. Little jokes, talk about Star Wars.
And usually we have all sorts of cool things planned, but this is a recovery week for us.
This is live on the air, and actually, for your thing, but I'm going to look at a text message here that's going to tell me who got kicked off American Idol, and I'm really nervous. But you
and your America... Oh.
You, because we're recording right in the middle of the show. I had someone text message me, but you read the disclaimer while
did you have that planned? You're can you text message me?
I said I was going to be doing this, and I thought about it all day. I hope it's not Taylor, but go ahead and read it. If it's Taylor, I'm going
to
howl like a monkey.
We have nothing to do with Lucasfilms, LucasArts, or Sony Online Entertainment. All parodies and impersonations are for...
Oh, my God!
Comedic effect only. If you don't find them funny or don't get it...
Oh, my God! Keep going!
Was it Taylor?
No, it wasn't Taylor!
Oh.
Go, 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 go!
Jeez.
Go.
If you don't find them funny or don't get it, blame String Theory, because it's pretty confusing.
String Theory.
the views presented in this show are solely of those of the creators and... that's about it.
My cats would be good with String Theory. Yeah,
yeah, they are. They're very good with that.
String Theory was invented by cats. Okay, here's the thing. American Idol. They're down to... I mean, I'm sorry to say
that's the wrong night for the podcast.
But no, sometimes it is the news. I mean, you're down to four people. I know you don't watch it, but it's a huge show.
All right,
Uncle Owen likes
it. Huge.
Yeah, they're down to four people. They're down to right. See, he likes it. They're down to ears.
Ears?
Well, Elliot.
What?
Elliot. He's like, I call him ears because he's got really big ears. They're down to the female is Kat, Catherine.
Catherine?
Yeah. And then you got Taylor Hicks, who's like Mr. I'm into everything. Woo! Like, he doesn't do as much woo as much anymore, but
he should do that.
Right. He's really passionate about the music.
I'm Taylor Hicks!
And then they're down to the rocker, Chris. Chris, the rocker, who has always dominated. He's done good. Anyway, blah, blah, blah. Last night, the theme was Elvis.
Yeah.
Yeah. They all did Elvis.
All right.
That's great. Okay. Everybody loves Elvis. Can't go wrong.
Right.
And
sure.
The female, she was at, Catherine was at a little disadvantage, everybody thought. Yeah, because you know,
she's
it's
a
Elvis.
Female.
It'd be like all the dudes doing.
That sounded
Madonna
terrible, by the
stuff.
Way, that I just said that.
How'd you say it?
I just said, because she's a female.
Well, I know you don't believe it.
No. Okay. Anyway, everybody knows what I meant because it's Elvis is
of
a
course,
male.
Of course. Right.
Whatever.
Of course. All right. Anyway.
Okay, I'm going to get all sorts of female
about that. Yeah, you are. Not really. Anyway, Chris the Rocker. Got voted off. My God, that's huge. I have people I know that are just going to crap their britches. I'm
really?
Not kidding. There is no way.
It's that important?
It is so huge. That's big. All right.
That's big news.
I know that.
I'm glad that you found
out
in your text message.
You were here as that happened.
I was here for the moment.
Because it is now.
The moment.
Wow.
Yeah. Whew. It's now what?
It's now or never, as Elvis would say.
Oh. All right. Are you going to sing that?
No, I'm not going to sing. Well,
cool.
Go for it.
So anyway.
Yep.
Here's our podcast.
American Idol.
Yeah. Now, Star Wars Galaxies.
Yep.
Star Wars. E3 is going on right now.
E3!
Yeah, and this week is just kind of like a let's see, like a chatting kind of just a filler.
Yeah.
It's a filler week.
Just a,
there's nothing crazy. Yeah, we don't have any good guests. No good guests. No. A little mishap in the beginning.
Never apologize. But yeah, okay, fine.
You know,
it's going
to
be fun.
I'd like to apologize for this
just
episode.
Just kick back, listen. If you're at work, get back to work. No. If you're at work.
If you're at work, screw work and listen to us.
Listen to us. Just put your feet on your desk.
School, if you're at school, do your work.
Do your homework.
First.
Always do your homework. But.
But listen to us in between.
Okay. If you're in your car, what?
If you're on your car, talk on your cell phone.
Okay. Right. Yeah. And if you're on your jetpack. Oh, you don't have a jetpack.
I really don't care if I have a jetpack.
Because you don't
have
one. The only people that poo-poo jetpacks are ones that don't have
one. Mr. Bubble.
Yes.
Mr. Bubble. What am I going to do with the jetpack in that game?
Fly around and taunt it to people that don't have one.
They've become so common now.
That's right.
I've seen them more and more.
But they're not.
What?
They're not common yet.
They're
more
common than
they
used to be.
Yes.
And it's like, to me, a jetpack, great. You can go, 10 meters off the ground. Woo, woo.
Do you have a jetpack?
I don't care.
Okay, because the only people that have your attitude are ones that do not have jetpacks, okay?
Seriously. I just don't get you.
I felt Obi-Wan once thought as you did. Obi-Wan got a jetpack.
Don't you forget it.
Owen had a jetpack.
That's, no.
He went up
Mr.
and down
Rubble?
Beggar's Canyon
Mr.
on his
Bubble.
Jetpack.
I told you to forget it.
That's all I'm going to say.
No.
No.
They're kind of clunky, though, aren't they?
Come on.
No, they are.
It's a kludge job.
It's a hack. Yeah.
It's a hack.
Yeah.
It's a hack that they even work. It's probably a looted item that wasn't supposed to work, but the NPCs had them, and then it was a bug, so they're like, we'll put that in the game.
I saw there's a forum post about them that someone was looking at an old movie clip of like a demo of Star Wars, or they saw it on a TV show about video games.
Yes.
And at the end of the Star Wars Galaxies clip, it had about 8 Mandalorian armored dudes on jetpacks flying in formation. And it was from
formation.
Yeah, it was from 2004. And they said, wait a minute, I don't think jetpacks were out then. When was that? And it just turns out that was like one of the developer things, like, come and look at what you can do in Star Wars.
Like the LucasArts website that still is outdated, as far as I know.
Right,
I haven't looked at it recently, I guess, but it's always outdated. It's like, try out one of the 32 wonderful professions.
Right, that's true.
We couldn't balance any of the professions.
Yeah.
That's my new voice for Helios.
Okay.
Hello.
Helios?
I'm Helios. This is how I talk. Look, this is not a real world simulation here, okay?
Right.
I'm sorry, if that's what you're looking for, you're not gonna get it.
That's pretty good.
Alright, I don't know. It's a little bit too Dr. Evil,
Dr. Evil, yeah.
A little bit Dr. Evil. No. I don't wanna do that. I don't wanna be like that. No.
Understood. Okay. We'll edit you out.
Good.
Fully, completely.
Can we just edit Helios?
Can I put you in carbonite and put you on the wall?
That'd be cool.
That'd be awesome.
Mm-hmm.
I could say, what does Java say? It's like, he says,
I like my new decoration.
I don't want to lose
something like that.
My prized possession.
Yeah.
Except he goes in Huttese.
Yeah.
He doesn't say, hi, I like my prized possession. Yeah.
I'm the spy. I'm iconic.
That way.
Yeah, make me.
They went.
It's kind of
that
like that.
What? No, I really think.
Oh, come on. It's a mouse droid.
Of course it's a mouse droid, but I'm in.
Well, you said, what is that? What was what?
And that's exactly how I sounded. No, like, once
listen, that's exactly how you sounded. What were they? Please tell me, people, did he not just sound like that?
All right, go ahead. What I'm getting at is, I think.
What made the sound?
Right, we had a discussion about that. We really don't know, but we think it is what?
A mouthpiece for a trumpet.
Probably, don't you think?
I really believe it is.
I think, can you play it again? Just picture a guy with like a little trumpet mouthpiece only, not the instrument.
All right.
Go. Yep. That kind of ruined it for me, dude. Now, that might not be a mouthpiece.
No, it's the same thing.
Oh.
Come on. Tell me that is not a trumpet.
If you play trumpet or cornet out there, try that in the mouthpiece. See if you can do that. Yeah. That'd be a funny trick.
I'm sure somebody can.
I think that the girls would really like it. If you're like in high school, I think they'd be so impressed.
They might be. You never know.
They say, is that a mouse droid?
Is that an MSE6 droid? Is that what that is? I wonder if I said that correctly.
It's an MSE
something. It's an MSE, though.
MSE, for sure. AKA mouse, yeah.
Yeah, because it sounds like mouse.
And then you say, yeah, baby, and it's got 10-item storage inside it, too.
Hey, baby. I'm happy to see you. Just look at my mouse droid.
Oh. Check out my little trumpet mouthpiece.
All right. I don't even know what this one is. That's like some guy going, gong.
Yeah, it's like a Mel Blanc one. Just
yeah.
Yep. All right.
Yogurt.
So where are we at?
Anyway,
script here. What did you
this
do
this week?
What did you do last week?
Well, first let's just get a couple things out of the way.
Okay, look, cross items off our list. All right.
Pieces of business.
Okay.
Pieces of flair. www.swgpodcast.com is where they can go and download it.
Right.
And some of our past episodes are there as well.
And the fact they're listening to it means they probably already know that, but yeah.
Well, unless they're at the on the forums and they click right on the direct link.
Oh, yeah.
You know, because they might not even know.
Right.
And they wouldn't know what they're missing. Not much. Or you can go to our new forums.
Yeah, they're missing their life.
We're not at the MySpace anymore.
No.
Because it's too many legal issues.
Weird
place and it's not safe.
It is. I mean, you know when you see a place
even
on...
Even as an adult, I feel bad going there.
I know.
You know, it's like... I'm scared, like, to find...
Yeah.
It's just bad.
No.
Anyway,
ever since the Today Show.
You can go there, but we're not checking that site really anymore.
No.
So go to www.yivvitsandmrbubble.com.
Right. Yeah, great domain name.
And if you can't spell our names, then you probably shouldn't go there.
Yeah.
No, you just go look in the forums.
Yeah, because we got that domain name. If we ever stop this, we can do our line of clothing or whatever. You know,
Yivvits and MrBubble. Yeah.
Our line of adult diapers.
No, Yivvits and Ascots by MrBubble.
Oh, yeah, right.
You can make ascots, and I'll make petticoats.
Oh, very. That'd be just perfect.
Mm,
can finally make armor, too. For our. Yeah. All right.
Nobody crafts anymore.
Yeah.
Sad.
So sad.
If you want to call us, you can call our number at 651 314.
Yep.
4357.
We should take some random calls next week, maybe.
Yeah, we'll just be able. Maybe we have a bunch of messages we have not played.
Yeah, right.
And I hope you've been checking them.
Yep.
Mm?
Maybe.
Have you?
Maybe.
Okay. Well, anyway, call, leave a message. It's just a voicemail.
Yeah, one was your mom. She was like, her car broke down, but that was like a week ago.
Yeah.
So sorry about that one.
Uh huh. Okay.
All right.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, what about last week? Let's talk about last week.
What
in
about
the game.
It, man? What do you want to know?
What did you do?
Well, we both did a lot of stuff.
I don't know where you were, what you're thinking. I wasn't there.
Sunday.
I was out of town Sunday.
Oh, please.
Okay, go ahead.
Please.
You keep going.
Odessia? Is it coming back to you, buddy?
No. I was
Dantooine?
I was on Dathomir.
Dathomir, okay.
The whole night.
Well, then who was I? What big free dude? Whatever. It was Dantooine.
There was all coming back now.
Battle of the Bands, which was very fun.
Yes, it was fun.
Way more fun than I thought.
Yeah, because we were worried because Odessia wasn't able to get enough people to sign up for it, just because there's not many people out there with bands anymore.
Don't know how she did it, but she did it.
But she got it together and got people there and just kind of an impromptu little talent show.
It was fun. Yeah.
It was fun. We were the judges.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But
Mr. Roland Yivvits. We had our own chairs, even. That was impressive.
Yeah.
We got to keep them. That was cool.
Yeah, because, like, what's she going to do with them?
Well, but still, it was cool. I mean, because, you know. I got a chair now. I mean, there's meaning attached to it. Even though it's just an item, you know, I can say, hey, that was when we did that.
Right.
What?
You're right. I'm agreeing. It's just because it was a sarcastic right.
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 Oh,
Prison Break.
No. What does it have to do with the
they got
the,
out. I'm just caught things that we've talked about
big
before.
Big deal. They got out of prison.
I know. It took them 20 episodes.
It's called Prison Break. I'm surprised it didn't happen sooner.
That's a joke. Anyway, just so you know.
Yeah.
Just in case you were wondering.
I was really worried about that.
You didn't. It was a surprise. Yeah.
It was a very big surprise.
Yes.
I was all like, oh my God, they got out of prison. That's really cool, man.
Yeah, I know. All right. It was a big plot twist, yeah.
Prison Break.
I know it doesn't have anything to do with Star Wars, but it has to do with
Let's see, we've had Prison Break now. Mm-hmm. We've had American Idol.
All on Fox. That network is just...
Star Wars Galaxies, is that on Fox?
No, but there's got to be some connection. 20th Century Fox, bam.
Oh, you're right.
Bam,
you're
connected.
Right. You're right.
It's 2 degrees, not even that.
2 degrees,
Thank you.
All right.
Kevin Bacon.
Let's finish talking about last week. Who won? We had lots of contestants.
Well, I know it got voted off.
I'm talking about the battle of the bands in Altera and Dantooine.
They're a friend.
Well, we had lots of people. Lots of friends were there.
Of course.
We had Mr. Happy and the Mr. Happy chicks.
His little ladies. That was cute.
And we had some previous players who hadn't been around for a while. Stacey Hagerith was there.
Yes.
And I apologize. I'm terrible with names, so if I'm forgetting people, you know, I have to say sorry all the time. Wookiees have a thing.
Okay. Wookiees are shy.
Who else do we? Corvin entertained.
Yep, Corvin was very good.
He did that. Yahe. he entertained.
And by the way, it's on Velsen. This is all this on Velsen. Yeah.
Yeah, this isn't in the real world.
No, no. Or on...
That talent show we're doing next week.
Yeah. Or on... It's not on Eclipse. It's not on... You know, it's on...
No, this is on Velsen. A very good server to be.
Yeah.
Yes. Why not? We had a lot of people come to our server.
Yeah.
Because of us.
Not
because
of us, though. Yeah.
That's scary.
I know.
Because I always think, what happens, like, they get here and everybody's
it's
really
like
mean?
It's like a rolling stone, man, that's just gathering. You know,
that's good.
That's good.
Even if you come there and make a tune just to go to our little parties, that's fun.
Just that. Because we had a good party after
we
the
did. We
Battle
had a party
Games.
Right on a big rock out there.
Mm-hmm. In Dantooine.
Yep.
Her
we had lots of people.
Altera.
Yep. We had the honorable Dak, our first place trivia
yes,
champ from
Dak.
Last week.
Mighty Dak.
He came. He made it. He needed to get a ride.
Yeah,
he, poor cute. Guy tried to walk.
2,000 meters.
Tried to walk, and he kept dying on Dantooine. I don't know why. Oh, the level, maybe. So
guy.
Swiftwind went and got him.
He needed a
very nice
pack.
Of Swiftwind. Yeah. She took off in her little TIE fighter.
Yep. Which you hate, yeah.
TIE fighter.
Insta-travel. Insta-travel
no, it's
vehicle.
It's an Imperial vehicle.
Oh, is that
it's
your problem?
Inferior.
Oh, please.
Imperial. Inferior.
Okay.
Kind of rhymes.
Yeah, those Rebels just have such good parts.
No, the neutrals. They got it all.
The newts.
The newts. The neuters.
Freelancers.
The freelancers. Yeah.
Privateer. Some cool ships.
Freelancer, whatever you want to call me.
The Rick Rack. Or
and the Wookiee for your job.
Okay, name three
okay,
freelancer
I can't.
Ships. Pronounce
okay,
them.
Okay, sick.
Pronounce them. Okay, sick. That's probably right.
Crate.
Oh, that's an easy one, but yeah.
YT-1300.
Nah. Okay, well, name, like, two of the hard ones.
Ixy-Lixy-Lon. The Rixer Hixiac.
Right.
And the Chemo Gilabina.
Yeah. I've
Chemo like, Cappuccino.
I'll take a 12-ounce chemo.
I'll take a
Grande.
Can I get a Grande Caramel Ixirana?
Yeah.
Or Rixi Rax?
With a 20-second booster. That's so nerdy.
It's pretty bad, man.
Boosters. Dude, there's no 20-second booster.
20 yeah. seconds?
There might be.
Really?
15 seconds. I don't know.
It could be. I don't know.
I don't know. Anything above 10 is great, if you're doing great.
Uncle Owen, do you know if there are any 20-second boosters out there?
How about in your T-16 Skyhopper? Nah, I guess not.
No. What they sold that, though. He didn't have a T-16, really. Luke had a T-16.
He had one, yeah.
Luke
back
did.
Home. Yeah.
I think.
Because he used to
I don't think Owen owned it. I bet Luke stole it.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, he's kind of a rebel like that. No, I mean, he was a rebel, but that was a bad pun.
Yeah.
No pun intended.
He was wasting time with his
what
friends.
Else did you do last week there, MrBubble?
There was
in
that,
the game.
Just in general. I mean, cut the grass.
Other than your TV shows that
oh, right.
everybody
yeah.
wants to hear about so much.
Yeah, yeah.
What did you do?
Bought dog food. Oh, you mean in the game, right?
Yeah,
right, yeah.
Bought dog food.
In
game.
There was, I couldn't sleep that night. I was so excited.
Yeah.
No, I don't know why it was. It was Sunday night after our party.
Okay.
I just couldn't sleep. You hit the rack and it's like, can't sleep. I turn on the crappy clock radio. Ugh, icky sounds.
Yeah.
You know, no good songs or anything. It was like our local FM stuff. So I'm just like do 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 do. You know, then okay, I'll go play the game again. So I just hop back on. I had my second win, and there was a mini.
Okay, now, but first of all,
yes,
explain partially why. You couldn't sleep.
Why?
There was a very particular reason.
What?
Didn't you have like four Starbucks or something? What was
no,
it?
No. It's just I experiment with the energy drinks. You know, I'm
yeah.
a bit on the show. They had what are they called? Vault.
Vault.
Starts with
I don't
V
know.
As in Victor.
Yeah. Whatever.
Let's say it's Vault. Vault. Is it Vault?
I don't know. It's one of those
it's
V's.
Valve.
Valve.
It's
copper valve.
Zero. But you know it's
no.
You know,
okay.
No, it's zero. It's the Valve Zero or Vault Zero.
All right. So it was sugar free.
Oh yeah. It's from the makers of Coke Zero. What more do you
okay.
want? Okay. What could possibly be wrong?
What then? Could possibly go wrong?
And they're just they're,
hey, it's me.
Hey, I like that one. I forgot that. Hey, it's me.
It's me.
Like
all right. So you had good. You had like what
well,
four of those
during our parties and stuff.
Oh,
I think
God.
I was up to four, but they went down so easy, you know. Just I sound like an alcoholic here, you know.
Like,
sound
like Smed.
Smed. Oh,
yeah. Yay! You really should try Red Bull instead. It gives you a much quicker buzz.
I know, but
it's much better.
But it wasn't really like an energy drink. It's just like a soda. That's all it is. Big deal.
See, that's how they get you.
That's right.
But I mean, you know, I think it's funny. They're all called energy drinks. Like they
yeah.
give you some kind of energy.
Well, see, this one has is this on the package? It says it has a kick of an energy drink, but the taste of a soda. It's like a combo.
Yeah, but still, it's an it, the whole thing is just caffeine. It's just a stimulant that's making your blood pressure go up. Like it's not giving you energy per se. I mean, if you ask me,
you're right.
It wired you. You're like, oh, I gotta go in. I can't go to sleep. I gotta play the game. I gotta go.
That's pretty close. That's pretty accurate, actually.
Probably.
Cut to 4 a.m. and then, like, I'm tired.
That was an impression. That was actually just me, but...
That was footage, yeah. Right, that's just how you feel right now.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so you had, like, 8 of those. So then you were up until what?
4.
4!
4 fingers.
So what did you do that whole time? Just space, or what?
A little of that, a little bit of space.
A little bit of bounty hunting?
A little bit of bounty hunting, more action. Yeah. A little bit of that, but then I got an email out of the blue that there's a post-party party on Tatooine.
I see how this works.
Yeah.
I see how this works.
There's no Yivvits around, man. And actually, it was the first party Ralph Stanley, my alt, has been to.
You shouldn't have said that, because now everybody's going to know.
That's okay. Ralph never gets to go to parties.
Well, why would you let him? He's a dirty imp.
He's an accountant and a bounty hunter.
It's worse. He's an imp.
Okay, whatever. Okay. But he went to a party, and he was, and I played him in character the whole time.
Oh, you role played.
I did a little RP. The accountant, yeah. So like, I did things like when this one character left, I said, like, you know, in spatial, Ralph Stanley gives her his business card. You know, things like that. Just like an accountant would, you know?
She's like, I'm not into propositions, man.
No. But it was funny. And people picked up on that. And then, like, she would say, like, someone else was handing out their business card.
You like the life of the party.
On spatial. Well, I'm just saying, people like the roleplay. Because they were looking at that, and then they were saying, like, so-and-so looks at a business card, notices, you know, some stupid... You know, it was fun. It was fun. That kind of stuff was fun. Did that for an hour and a half.
You have the Emperor's official seal of...
Right.
You're an Imperial Notary. Yep. You're an Imperial Notary Public.
Signed by... I will add that. Thank you.
Thank you. You can just put that in there, too. Thanks to the Yivvits.
I will not do that.
Yivvits trained him.
Claim it as my own.
No, you will not.
I will.
Okay. So I get it now. The parties that are, you know, the after party.
Oh, yeah, baby.
That happens
when you go to
where? Usually Tatooine, I suppose, huh?
Depends.
Because I don't like it all. It gets all sandy in my fur.
Oh, right. You know? We just wait for you to log off. I mean, it's pretty simple.
Right. So I see where that's going.
So everybody out there, if you see Yivvits logging off, wait like 5 or 10 minutes, make sure he's really logged off, and then we'll tell you where the after
party. And then what, log back in?
What?
Well...
No, we'll wait for you to log off. We'll wait 10 minutes to make sure you are logged off.
But see, if everybody stays online, see, usually people leave, too. They log off when they're done with their party. Okay.
If you see the Yivvits log off...
Why am I helping? Wait a minute. Why am I helping them figure this out?
Got it. Done. This is it. If you see Yivvits log off, you log off. You wait 10 minutes, you log back in.
Should they close X-Fire, too?
Mm.
If they have
yes. it? Yes. 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 Okay. And leave it closed.
Oh, okay. Like you.
Right. Okay, anyway. No.
Oh.
All right.
Oh, my.
But no, that was an after-party party. After that, I mean, I've just been grinding in space for Ralph.
You know,
Ralph,
how long have you been grinding him?
I'm really slow. I can only do about an hour at a time. And
Savage Sniper isn't ulted. He did like a week.
And he's also in high school, all right?
Well, yeah, but still.
Well,
same hour.
When I was in high school, I came home from high school. 3 o'clock.
We don't want to know about that for two hours after you got there.
This is it. These kids have that extra 2 hours of very productive computer time that as adults you don't get a lot. I know. I look back. That was the best computer video game time of my life.
I'm going back to high school.
Right. Just because was I in sports? Absolutely not. No. Absolutely not. No. I was in band. Look at me. Was I in sports?
No.
Pizza eating? Maybe. Right.
No.
If that was a sport, I'd be champion. I'd have the big letter P.
No.
Yeah. Pizza topping, assembling,
pizza
theory.
Pepperoni.
I got a PhD in that. Whatever. I did my 200-page thesis.
Well, you sound like a regular pizza theorist.
Domino's alone, yeah. Right. Delivery strategies, paths, all that stuff. Optimization, temperature control.
Those are very important things.
Oh, yeah. I was.
So where was this going again?
I was fundamental on the 3-stage oven, you know, the conveyor belt one.
Right.
I did my thesis on that because you got the conveyor belt going through the oven.
Yeah.
You don't keep it the same temperature all the time. I was trying to find that optimal point in the oven where you have the maximum temperature to get the golden brown on the cheese.
Mm.
And then, but then you have it taper off as it comes out. So,
right. so it gets right. the crust nice and crusty.
Yeah, what were we talking about?
You were talking about Ralph Stanley. And then you went on this weird thing about pizza.
These kids have 2 hours that we don't have. Cuckoo. They get home at 3:30. They do whatever they want for 2 hours.
Yeah.
And then it's supper time, which is made for them probably. Oh.
Gosh.
And you and I, we...
We starve.
Yeah. Let's see. Come home from work and then do that stuff the rest of the night because we don't have to do homework.
Well, yeah, usually you get home, though, and you know, it's... A lot of times they get home late.
Yes.
So it's like 6
yes.
instead of 5.
Still don't have to do homework.
Yeah, I know. But then I get in, then I want to read the form, and then I want to check on stuff. And, you know, then I spend about, I spend like 4 or 5 hours a night preparing for each week's podcast.
Oh, right. Yeah, each night. Yeah, me too.
And
we
then,
do have a conference call, though.
We finally
got going on that.
We still, yes.
2 weeks in a row.
Yep. We don't have the polycoms ready yet, though.
No, but we did it.
If anybody wants to donate polycoms.
Right, we need a pair of those. And a big oak table for my office. And big leatherback chairs.
That won't fit in your bathroom. That's your office. So.
That's my office. That's my
it's
reading
your thinking room.
My reading room.
It's where you do all your best thinking.
Yeah, but that's... Ralph did a lot of grinding.
Did a lot of
trying thinking. To. And along the way... Inspiration buffs. Inspiration buffs.
Were you inspired?
Inspiration buffs. Generic ones. If you're a pilot, because, I mean, I know a lot of people know this, but a lot of people don't, because I didn't know.
Well, explain.
Okay, here's the thing. Go to an entertainer. If you're about to grind in space, if you're doing your tier 4 grinding, go to an entertainer. Say, I need a general inspiration buff. They'd be more than happy to give you one. You have to look at them or watch them.
Right.
It takes 3 minutes out of your life.
Then tip them.
And tip them. Give them 50K. Give
yeah,
them whatever.
Not like 10K, you no, cheap
no,
boys.
No, because here's what it gives you. You launch into space, everything else is the same. Every time, you know, if you get 3,000 XP, you get 10% more. You get 3,300 XP.
Ooh.
It says right there, 10% inspiration bonus. It tells you right there.
Right. See, what now, before people, I think people gave up on them because they hadn't been working for a while.
Right, right.
So...
Was that fixed in 28 or what?
I think it was 28. And then they weren't lasting very long. And then 28.87627, they fixed that.
Because this can go up to 3 hours.
Correct.
And which is a nice grind session. And, you know, if you grind 700,000 points, yeah, it's like an extra 70,000 on there.
It adds.
Why not?
It adds a little bit on there. It adds.
It's just fun. Because once you have them a few times, then you feel ripped off if you don't have it.
Can I say that I will never understand... Well, I never understand the NGE, but the thing I will never, never understand is why they had to change the way the space thing progresses. That's just so stupid.
Oh,
it made
wheels?
So much sense before.
Yeah,
and wheels. Now it's so confusing as to what you can use when, and it's a simple little wheel. What could be easier than a wheel?
Wheel of cheese.
Yeah. Wheel. I mean, they're trying to oversimplify and end up making it just as doggone stupid as they can.
I agree, though. I don't like the wheels.
The wheels got to go. And the iconic pictures.
Yeah.
Oh, please.
What's confusing for me on the wheel is, are you talking about how on the wheels you really can't tell what you have and what you want?
Well, yeah, exactly. Like, where do I get this skill?
Yeah.
You know, okay, well, it shows me I get plus 15 of this.
Oh, forget it.
Yeah. and shut up.
Yeah.
that was a misfire. Yeah. Mistel. It was an Owen Mistel.
Owen Mistel.
Oh, anyway. I can't. I don't know. The wheels just are stupid. I think back in the pre-combat upgrade days, even though like now you couldn't do that as much, something like that made a lot of sense because it would say, no, but it was nice because you could hover over a box.
Yeah, yes, yes.
Then it said, okay, here you can start using this weapon and you can wear this armor, which doesn't matter now, obviously, but you could use this weapon and you gain this skill, which did this. And now it's like, oh, I'm on wheel number 3.
You gotta admit, though, with the traitor, that's a fine-looking picture of Lando.
You know what? I could care less.
That's the part of the Lando system right there.
Yeah.
That's suave.
That's just stupid.
He's just like, hey.
We don't need Lando on there.
That'd be like on the cover of the men's players book. Mm-hmm. Yeah. He's like,
don't get me started.
You do belong with us here among the clans.
Oh, you do belong here among us with a gimped profession.
In the sands of Tatooine. Yeah. Okay. Good rant about the wheels. I don't think the wheels are optimized.
Yet. Wheels are ridiculously stupid,
it's
people.
It's a gauge. I mean, it shouldn't be hard, cause especially if it's gated and on the rails and there's no deviation possible.
The combat level is just stupid. I mean, I don't know if it'll hurt me. I better look at the combat level.
No, that's something else. I mean,
no, that's what it was for. That's why they showed it. That's because if it's a level above you, you might get killed, but it doesn't matter. You can take stuff down 10 levels above
20,
you.
20, even.
So
yeah.
Just take the levels out already. They can be there. I don't care. Just bring some more realistic back to the game.
They were always there behind the scenes.
Shut up, Helios.
I know. Remember them saying that, though? The first.
I don't care what you say.
They were always there. It's just you never saw them.
Yeah, it was a lot more interesting when I could go and examine a creature and it would say, does this, has this attack, and it's a stalker.
See, you already
which was a leftover.
You already lost me, though. I mean,
yeah, I lost you like 8 episodes ago.
I know, but that's why they
switched. I lost you like 20 episodes ago.
You wish.
Look, if you still wanted to go into space and just do your thing, no different.
No different.
I'll say it once. Say it again. This is a revamp show, so I can say this kind of crap.
Fine.
Or whatever you want to call it.
Okay.
Rehash.
Wanted to throw in the garbage. Yeah.
It's just going to go right in the recycle bin.
Oh, yeah.
Oops. No, they just... uh-oh.
Oops, I erased it. Oops.
Nothing. So...
I can't believe you left the microphones on, by the way.
Let it go.
I'll let it go. I better remember to edit that crap out.
Yeah, you won't.
That's embarrassing.
That's all right.
I hope so.
They never had to balance 32 professions. All they had to do was just make the content like they did for the main iconic ones. Those would be your profession, right?
Yeah.
But then you just pick your skills based off of that, and that's what they're going back to now, to some degree. But let's lose the wheels. Please.
Wheels are good with cheese, cars.
And radial menus.
Radial menus are good.
I'm serious. The radial menu system just worked. Ever since they've removed that crap, it's made so many problems with the interface. You know what my new favorite one is?
No one. Oh, here we go. What?
Should I do my user interface rant?
I'm just going to kick back here.
You need to comment, too.
Of course I am. I'm kicking back. Go for it. Go ready, go.
All right. I've said it before. I've said that before, too.
I'm over here if you need me.
All right. Are you comfortable?
Yep. Oh, that's great.
All right. So, how many times have I talked about this, that the user interface is more important than it's given, you know? They just don't care.
Approximately 17.3 times.
Thank you. Thank you, EV99.
Yeah.
EV82. Is that kind of like...
EV812.
EV, isn't that that econo fuel that's made with like 82%?
I think so.
Yeah, E82. Thank you. Thank you. That's been that was brought to you from the Minnesota Corn Growers Association.
We'll edit that out.
The user interface is just so ridiculously stupid, just beyond all belief. It just needs to be revamped or fixed. And the thing I keep seeing in the forums by some of the galactic senators is, well, they've said before that...
I am a galactic senator.
No, but they said before, somebody posted the other day, I don't remember if it was Badger or Sushi or Minced Meat or who it was. Meat Puppet, one of those two. They say that, they've said that the developers have stated that they changed the way the whole UI works under the, under the hood. And I say BS to that. I call them on that. I'm not a developer, but I've seen the UI mod for that to get some of your old UI back.
Mm-hmm.
There's, as far as I can see, there's no major change there. I mean, what could you possibly do under the hood that would break your ability to resize an image like the radar? I mean, you've done a little bit of programming, right?
Yeah.
I mean, it's an object-oriented thing and all that kind of stuff. We're talking about an image map or some type or a graphic. What engine could you possibly change that makes it so you cannot resize something like the radar? Or make it so you can move around the journal window or the journal thing or turn it off. I mean, these things are just ridiculously stupid that they're saying that they can't because it's so much work. I have my theories of why it actually is like that. I think it's because it was a leftover from their plan to go to console.
Oh.
And I think they were originally planning that, and then they're like, oh crap, this isn't working out. And then they canceled it, and I'm sure there's the conspiracy people out there that say it's still doing it. I don't think it is, because it would take a lot of work at this point for them to do that. But that, to me, is one reason why, they lock that stuff down, because on a console, you don't want people moving around their windows all the time and, making it so they can't find what they happened to their UI. Where did my journal window go?
You know what? If I'm going to say one thing,
yeah.
I can't believe how many publishes it's been since this bug has been out there, but... the one where you landed a starport and your little waypoints click up a notch.
Yes.
Can you believe that bug is still out there?
Kashyyyk, when you go to the map there, and you want to buy a ticket, all the waypoints for the stations are like a complete off of the map.
Right.
Hello, that was out over a year ago now. Over a year ago.
Are we above the year anniversary of that? I forget.
It was my birthday.
Oh,
you know,
yeah, but
a nice birthday gift, right? The combat upgrade.
Yeah.
Happy birthday. You're screwed.
I don't want to get too much in your personal life, but I did give you a birthday present. What was it?
Can I say it on the air?
Sure.
Oh.
You silly.
It was a die cast of the ARC 170.
Thank you.
Very nice.
Three pilot.
Very nice.
Yes.
Yes. And I appreciate that.
I love passing it around to the people who, because I did actually get a little celebration. I'm not going to get too much into it.
That's all right. It was my house.
The people.
It was my golden birthday.
Yeah.
Yeah. So. Yes.
All right. Goldenrod.
All right. Hurry up, Goldenrod.
Right.
You're permanent resident.
It's always funny to look, because you and I, it's funny, we know we're each other's into Star Wars.
Yeah.
Our immediate family knows we're into Star Wars, so it's not a big deal. What I like are the people that don't know we're into Star Wars. And I was passing around that ARC 170, and some of these people would get it, and they're like, oh, okay.
Yeah, so he's 29.
I live for that. I just live for that.
He's doing a Star Wars thing?
Yeah. And then I'm like,
it'd be funny if you got, like, Legos.
Oh! Because
I would have thought they were cool.
Next time.
You know?
But I like people.
It's a very nice die cast.
Well, of course!
It's hermetically sealed.
Of course. Nitrogen filled.
It's nitrogen filled canister.
I hope you didn't break the seal.
No.
I mean,
because
I got a team from the Smithsonian to help me with that display case.
You
can get the Declaration of Independence in
there. Yeah, it's okay still.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Xenon gas in there.
Yeah. Where can you buy xenon gas?
Quick Trip.
Okay. Quick Trip. They got a tank exchange out front,
the propane.
Like the propane.
Propane
and
propane accessories.
Yeah.
All right.
Xenon accessories.
Xenon gas.
So the user interface, it's just, I don't know. Yeah, stuff like that.
Yeah.
This stuff should be basic. I mean, if you're going to put something in the game or fix something,
basic.
To me, it's just so important. The way that you interact with something has to be done right. You have companies spending millions of dollars on research on user interfaces because it's how you use the system.
Like Apple.
So they can put, okay, I'll give you that, like Apple.
Yeah.
Microsoft does it too.
They rip off Apple, right.
Okay. I'll let that go.
Right.
So I'm a nice guy.
Because Apple rips off other people, and then Microsoft rips off Apple, and Linux rips off Microsoft.
It's a vicious cycle.
It is.
Where does it start? I'm sure it
Xerox.
Starts with Apple.
Xerox.
Starts with...
I think...
Starts with the Commodore.
Not really the Commodore Amiga?
Yeah.
Sorry.
I don't know what to really say. I mean, I keep seeing these posts, and I made a post in the forum saying, they made a poll in the forums asking about this new Logitech keyboard.
Oh yeah, it looks awesome.
Yeah, what is it, like the G5? I don't know, some weird number. Anyway, it's got two rows of special keys on it and a display on it to display things from the game. And they're saying, have you heard of this thing? Would you consider buying it? And should we consider adding support for it? I'm thinking, okay, let's see. Borked up UI since like 2 years ago, a year ago since a combat upgrade, or add support for this other keyboard for a vendor. That's really, let's see. I'm going to go with order pizza maybe instead. I mean, is there a choice C?
You say that for anything.
People, and then they're saying, well, they're trying to make vendor relationships. They got to make relationship. You know, when does our relationship with us start to matter more?
Well said, actually.
They have been trying, and they have improved their relationship because they've done better on their publishers lately.
Yeah.
I will give them that. There's still been bugs.
Of course.
But they've been trying to work them out more.
They've pretty much done what they said, too, for a long time.
So far. But the thing that I see missing still is that it's always they come out with the information, after they've decided the way it's going to be, they say, how do you like this?
Yeah.
And it's like, well, okay, so we decided now from your feedback that we're going to change it like this, but we can't really do it like you're wanting because of the system's already, that's how the system is. It's like, well, then why did you even ask us?
I mean, they wouldn't
ask us if we wanted that keyboard unless they had already had tons of meetings to figure out if they could and how to do it and strategies right. and all that stuff.
Well,
because so it's already done. The deal's probably already done.
Yeah,
they probably already figured out everything. Why would you announce?
And sure, I know they need marketer support and stuff, but. Yeah. When are they going to start fixing the damn game
more? Are you going to try the keyboard? Seriously?
No. I'm not going to get around their borked up user interface and control scheme by having to buy a keyboard with 24 buttons on it.
What does the display do? Can you? Is it text?
Does it matter?
I'm just wondering, though.
No, I will not buy it on the principle.
Okay.
I will not buy it on the principle.
That's valid.
And neither should you.
Did you buy a keyboard with a Windows key? Because, I mean, the same thing.
It came with it.
I know.
Give me a break.
Okay, well, let's say your next system comes with this one. Will you use it? You could.
That's invalid. You're trying to make an argument for something that's not arguable.
The only thing I just want a keyboard with lights on it. That'd be cool.
You can get that.
Well, let's get.
What this comes down to is they're saying you want to add this keyboard that does all these extra buttons and all this crap, and you know I let me resize the damn radar. Let me change it so my chat tabs I can actually pull them off and then put them back on.
All right.
Because now they pull off okay, but you got to delete them. Mm. And let's make it so sometimes when I go into alt mode, my cursor is kind of stuck and I have to
right
click.
Right.
That gets stuck. Okay.
That's still buggy, isn't it?
That's still buggy. Yeah. Oh, how about this? Every time I've gone and done a radial menu for something lately, for harvesters mainly, after I click on the radial and then close the window I was in, my cursor ends up in either the upper right hand or upper left hand corner of the screen.
You're right about
that. And it alternates.
Yep. Yep.
And that's annoying. I mean, this is simple stuff. This is low level. If you can't fix this stuff and see that it's important, how do you think anybody's really going to get past that stuff in the long run? Not just the flashy crap, you know, your Galactic Civil War editions you're going to add. This is like how we use the game. And if they would fix it, do you not think that maybe people would enjoy it just a little bit more because they could customize the system to work more towards their needs? Mm-hmm. And it isn't about adding skins to me. And it's not even about the second toolbar, although it makes complete sense to have that second row. I look at other games, and I'll just use an NCSoft, City of Villains. Mm. I can have three toolbar rows if I want. I can pull menus off, I can whatever, I can move them all over. I don't need to be able to skin it like WoW. I could care less if I could make it look like a Counter-Strike elite pawnage thing, you know, pwnage. I just want it so I can move things around. I can make it so it looks clean and not so over-the-top, flashy, glitzy, gaudy. And I'll say it one more time. Move things around, resize things, and have a UI that's consistent. That doesn't just act however it thinks it kind of wants to act sometimes. Oh, you clicked on your inventory. I think I'll resort everything again. I mean, any of those windows, none of them remember their size anymore.
No.
None of them remember their position.
I don't like
none of them remember their sort order. I mean, this is 2 years now, and we cannot get an interface that works right. And they say, well, it's you want other things added to the game right now, like this stuff.
2 years since what? 2 years since what?
Well, I mean, some of that stuff's never worked. Like sorting?
3 years.
3 years, thank you. Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, and a year since the combat upgrade when a lot of problems started.
Mm-hmm.
And how long since the NGE now? 6-7 months?
Yeah, November. Oh, God, yeah, that goes fast.
I mean,
wow.
You know, you can add all you want, but fix these low-level things because they're more important. They are more important than most people want to give them measure for.
Dude, we are 6 months since the NG happened.
And look where we are.
That flew so fast.
Yeah, it was supposed to be finished by now. So give us 6 months. Oh, I'm sorry. They said give us six more.
Yeah.
We're going to squash out every bug this year. I don't know. I'll give them a break on that, but I will not accept, especially from the senators, the fact that they're trying to defend that. It is a low-level thing. It is the very core of how you use that game that has problems.
It's the user interface.
And if as long as that's that way, no one's going to fully enjoy, even though they might really enjoy it, they're not going to the extent that they probably could if the user interface worked properly as it should. And that's that.
And that's all I gotta say about that. No, that was a good rant, Yivvits.
I'm not. It's
joking.
It's not defendable. I'm sorry. If the senators, whatever, some of them seem to think it's okay. Some of them try to say, and they all say they're not denying that it's not broken, but they're trying to say, well, you know, they want to get support for the other priorities.
Yeah,
you know, they got.
That.
I'm sorry. This should be the very bottom. I mean, not the bottom of the list. This is what the base is on. You know, and with the NGE, they didn't change the game engine. They changed the way the game engine works.
Right.
You know, the game engine's still there. So you cannot tell me that there's something that they did to that interface that makes it so you cannot do these things. I ask you.
Well, they might.
Why can't you do that?
Yes, yes. They might have deleted a chunk of something that they just can't put back. I mean, they probably did.
I don't, and I'm not gonna. I will not condone UI mods, that kind of stuff.
Right, right.
But look, it's simple. I mean, it's just a quick little thing. You get half the stuff back the way it was. But also, they're the way that they treat those things is just, it's a little strange because, you know. I'm not going to, you know what, I'm not going to go into it because I don't want to get us in trouble.
It's well done, though.
But it's just stupid. They just got to fix it. There's no excuse.
All right.
No excuse, Smed.
Trivia.
Or Chris. Or Rogue.
Let's salute our winners.
Or Helios. And I'm going to keep going all the episode. Okay, anyway. Seriously, go through the forums and any thread you see, if you agree with that, please post constructive comments as to why it's important.
Yep.
And maybe we can get somewhere because they seem to listen a little bit better now. Hopefully, we can get something.
Right.
And just it's getting old. Anyway, let's go on. Trivia, we're done for now.
I know, but who won?
Well,
recap.
Third place final was Alaric.
Yep.
And Rebel. Second place was Haphazard.
See, Rebel.
I don't remember.
I don't think so.
I'm sorry. First place was Dak. Good old Dak.
Real.
He
used to be Rebel.
He owned.
Yes!
Boom, headshot.
He brought
Boom,
it.
Boom, trivia headshot.
He brought it. he knew how many manipulator arms were on a Probot, even though they're called legs. Yeah, I know. There was some discussion about that.
They hang down. It could be an arm or a leg.
Exactly. Because the component
appendage
is a takes a manipulator arm package set.
Oh.
So it's a thing. That is
You're assuming that droid engineers are needed.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, please. No.
You're done.
I'm done. I still am droid engineer. I just don't.
I think you should respect Jedi. Jedi.
Respect. Yeah.
No, don't do Jedi.
I don't have Jedi.
No.
All right. Anyway, I'm very happy with where I am.
Yeah, we had a great... So the trivia, that's done.
That was fun.
That was a lot of fun. We'll do it again sometime.
Yeah.
We'll mix it up, do it differently.
Oh, yeah.
You know, a lot of people that got interested in it finally.
Mm-hmm.
And started to get more people calling and asking.
We'll call people in the phone book randomly.
Hey, this is Yivvits.
What's a podcast?
There is. Right, right.
Oh, that's Chris Cow's mom. Sorry.
Yeah. Chris, are you doing your cast pod again?
All right.
What's up?
None.
What else?
News. E3. This is a big video game week.
It is E3.
Yep.
So I wonder if we're going to hear about the big thing.
Well, isn't there anything that we know yet? Or for sure or nothing for sure?
Maybe.
Well, what do we maybe know?
Maybe not.
Okay.
No, we maybe know, and it sounds like it probably is. It's a Galactic Civil War kind of expansion on Rory.
Rory!
Rory! And it'll be focused on a city, although as of yet I have not seen the detail if it's one that's already there. I assume it's one that's there. I'm going to guess Restus.
Okay.
Because Normally is used in some quests.
There are a lot of quests there, yeah.
So, yeah, FedEx quests. Mm-hmm. Like the Nim one, which that Star Map one, ridiculously. How is that fun?
That is not fun.
How is that a fun quest?
That's one of the lamest quests ever.
I go here, yep. I go here, yep. I come back here, yep. I come back here.
It just takes time.
I shoot here.
You can almost macro it.
You almost could.
Yeah.
That's just stupid. Yeah, so I think it's going to be Restus, and I think it sounds like they're going to have some kind of a thing where you'll do quests, and then at some point, after you finish some things, enough players or something like this. It's very vague at this point, because I don't want to give out false information. And they said at some point you'll unlock this battle that'll happen, and it essentially blows up the city. The city's like nuked. So then it becomes a PvP zone.
Yeah, you know, I don't have a problem with this.
Well, I don't have a problem with it. I wasn't expecting anything massive, to be honest with you, because we all have seen what they've been able, what this team has been able to do lately, and it's not been a whole hell of a lot.
No,
I mean, I'll give them their credits for trying to do things, but it's just not there.
It's like
not
the
getting
same old crap.
It's not getting back to where it was.
It's like polishing a turd.
Yeah, yeah. You're taking a spoon. You're trying to polish that thing out. It's like, oh, yeah, it looks a little smoother now.
Yeah,
it got the cracks out of it.
Still a turd.
Yeah. So One thing the person mentioned is it looked like you'll be able to go in like buildings on the second floor of the building and shoot off the building. And hello, Counter-Strike or
how'd they do that?
Day of Defeat. You know, it's PvP, I think, and that's what people want. The one thing that sounds weird though is it's a one-time event. So if you miss that main event, I mean, you cannot do it again. I mean, it's.
I don't have a problem with that. I was thinking about that. I don't have a problem with
that.
I think
it should be more like The Village, though, where it's repeated. Oh. Like, there's phases where there's a battle that rages up to it. And then maybe there could be, like, two different outcomes. Like, you could have an outcome for the Rebels.
Yeah, but because here's... I mean, the bottom line is they're changing a city to a PvP zone. How many times can you... You can only do that once. I mean, right?
I suppose that they have to change the technology.
I mean, what are they going to say that? For some people, that's
what I don't understand is how they're going to make...
I just think you can't bear to let a gorgeous guy like me out of your sight.
I just think you're not going to be able to get 50 people in there and not leg to death.
Oh,
you know, I mean, you come to our parties.
Yeah, right, right.
And we got maybe, you know, we never counted, but yeah. I'd say the top has been close to 100.
It could be.
Close. So we're probably anywhere from, at the peak of the party, maybe 30 to 50.
And the most we are doing is maybe having Nargalong out or something. Yeah.
And then the very top, it might be 100 or something for the most busy ones. Like the Miss Velson party was big.
Huge. Miss Velson was huge. Yep. A lot of people there.
And it gets terrible. I mean, you can go and turn down all your graphics. I turn off all the vegetation crap, all the, you know, the non-collidable and the collidable.
I'm in amber text mode.
Yeah, you're in amber, Ted. Yeah, you have two colors.
I got my Hercules.
Amber and off.
Hercules monochrome card going.
And it's not even in monochrome. It's just, you know, amber or black. And it's bad. And there's, like, only just a few musicians doing their little effects. And then you got the Jedi. They're going to be battling it out because it'll be mainly just be Jedi, of course.
Oh, of course.
And they're going to have all their little flashy particle effects going and all this stuff. How is that going to work?
Well, I just hope it's not like the same horsepower that a city has. I really think they'll throw some more horsepower at it. They'd have to.
Well, it doesn't seem like it's a problem with horsepower and the server. I think it has more to do with the way the code works.
Oh, okay.
I mean, the code just wasn't really made for that. That's why they maybe couldn't get it to work in the first place.
Well, maybe they'll think about it. I mean, come on. Let's benefit of the doubt. We haven't played it
yet.
You
know what?
So
I know what it is.
What?
You have to have that keyboard. Because the keyboard will have, the keyboard probably has like a 386 processor in it.
Yeah.
And that's a little bit on the client side really helps.
I think they're making it for the new Nintendo Wii controller.
Wii!
The Wiimote.
The Wiimote. Which I'm not sold 100% on that yet, but I'm getting there.
You tried it.
Do not give me that. You've tried it, haven't you?
Well, I can't believe you're making a pin on it without trying it.
Come on, just look at them. Look at them playing it.
All right. It looks cool.
It could be.
It could
we'll
be.
See.
We don't know because I haven't tried it.
I want it to be because it's Nintendo.
Of course.
You know?
And is there anybody out there other than Nintendo that could do it right? Sony? No. Microsoft?
No.
Hell no.
Because Microsoft would first over-engineer it, or they'd steal it from Nintendo, but they get it wrong.
Right.
Sony would say, we're going to support it. But we're only going to have third-party vendors make this stuff, so you got to go buy your controller from Mad Catz or something.
Mad Catz. You have to get it from Korea.
Yeah. It's like... you got to order... That's like... Isn't it one of the brands?
You're right. It's like the cheesy little...
It's like, come on. You can buy all your accessories from them.
Some Lixan or that place.
Nintendo's accessories has always been rock solid.
And I think... Because we talk a lot about this other than Star, but like we love... Is it the Wavebird? Is that the name of it?
Oh, the Wavebird's a great controller.
Engineering.
Wireless is...
Oh.
Best wireless.
They did it right. It took them a long time, and there were tons of other wireless controllers.
And there are ones for the PS2 that you try.
Of course. I got one from Korea, and it just was this Wavebird. My God.
It works like from
what a good
way far away.
Yeah, the Nintendo waited forever and did
it
right.
But it takes batteries.
Yes, it does.
Oh, so what?
What do you want it to run on solar?
Your cell phone only lasts 3 days.
Yeah, it's like 100
the controller,
hours.
The controller
thing.
Lasts like on a double A's. What is it? It's like
100 hours or
hours,
more.
hours.
It's just not an issue.
No, it's a non-issue.
Well, more hours than you can imagine.
Well, more hours than a C battery.
Except for that kid who has that extra 2 hours a day. From school.
Those kids, there's a thing with the younger generation. They're a lot of them just aren't into games that are good games.
Like Pong, right.
Yeah, like Pong, Mr. Bubble.
Well, what are you saying?
No, like...
Because this argument's been going on since Pong. But go ahead, what are you going to say?
Like, shoot 'em up, kill 'em games. And there's nothing wrong with a good shoot 'em up, kill 'em game. But, I so own in Halo, dude.
I see this as a good sign. This is just like music. Every generation of music thinks the previous generation was out of touch, and the previous generation thinks the next generation is just insane because their music is so impossible to understand. It goes back to Greek times. It goes way back.
So this is good, you're saying?
It's good. It's not, so we're, it's right? Not good or bad. No. It's just part of the trend. It's just...
I thought I was right. Well, all the time.
You're always right, buddy.
Okay, thanks.
You're completely right.
I needed that for myself's confidence.
Come on. I mean, people in the 60s thought the 40s music was square. The people who loved the 40s music thought the 60s was devil music. And that continues to this day. That continues to this day.
Music from the 60s is devil music. Elvis,
Beelzebub. Big time. Yeah. don't be mocking the king at all.
Come on. Right. I told you to forget it.
Yeah, right. Right. Don't even touch the king.
Anyway, what were we talking about there before that?
In the ghetto.
No, we were talking about...
Taylor did in the ghetto last night, Yivvits.
I just don't care about Taylor Hicks.
Just so you know.
You know his last name! Because you talk about it every podcast.
I love it.
Every episode of this show lately.
It's important.
I gotta see if Taylor got voted off. My man.
He's my man. He's my man. I used to mock him.
He's my man. He's my man.
Woo! Go woo.
He's my man.
He's my man.
Woo!
That's right. That's Taylor. He doesn't do that as much anymore, though, but see, you got it. You got it. You got it. Yeah, Taylor. And the gray hair. What's with the gray hair, too?
Oh.
All right. I still ease my mind. All the way to the end, I'm going Taylor.
Once you go Taylor.
Yeah. See, Taylor, that profession is gone now, isn't it, Taylor?
Just about. Just about. They did a pretty good job of that.
When I say Taylor, I'm talking about the profession.
I'm sorry.
No.
When you say, when you mean Taylor Hicks, you mean like those Hicks that still play Taylor?
Right.
Yeah, those Hicks out there.
Exactly. From the UOT.
What are you doing? Oh, UOT's closing.
I know. That's why I dropped it. Yeah.
That's sad. Yeah. I remember many, many times back in when I first started
sentimental music. Go. Okay, go.
No, don't give me that crap.
I'm giving you crap. Go.
Half the people that play the game or don't even realize what was there before, because it's all about
better
owning.
Yeah.
No. Don't. No.
Okay.
It was better. You could go in there at vendors for,
you know,
1,000 meters into the city.
Yeah.
And not just that city. There were other places, too.
Mm-hmm.
And it was great because there was no vendor search. And I know that that, for a lot of people, was a problem because I can see how that was a pain. But I liked the fact that you had to go out and find stuff. I could look, I could find where a certain type of vendor was, but I had to go kind of figure it out and shop and stuff. That was fun. So you could spend a whole day and just looking around for stuff on those vendors in UOT City and the mall. Personally, I always thought some of the UOT stuff made by UOT and the main people there was a little overpriced.
Some?
Yeah, okay, a lot of
it. Oh, please.
But, but they were definitely a major part of the server, no matter what you say about their prices, they had good product.
It was a, yes.
They had good product,
yeah.
So,
yeah.
I guess there's two sides to that, There's one is that they had the good product. If you wanted it, that's usually what you paid for. But it's sad to see that go. They're closing it, so.
Yeah.
It's been gone for kind of a while. Mr. Trips, I think, tried to keep it going. I don't know if he's leaving or what, but anyway, so it's sad to see that go. Yeah, UOT. Can you cue like a taps or something here?
No.
In the background? No.
No.
Oh, wait.
It should be celebration music. Yeah, it's...
C-3PO.
Just kidding.
What does Jabba think about UOT?
His High Exaltedness, the Great Jabba the Hutt, has decreed that you are to be terminated immediately.
See how sad he is? Immediately.
Let's kick it up a notch. Do you have any music there you can play?
What, are we getting close to the end already?
I don't have anything. What else you got?
Well, I don't know. There's nothing to really talk about as far as news.
No. Just that the Nintendo Wii. They might have a Star Wars game coming out.
Oh, there might be. Not Star Wars Galaxies?
No,
what?
No. But it might be good.
Hey, maybe their controller would actually work. That'd be the next poll. Let me go see if it's on there. Would you support if we added support for the Nintendo Wiimote?
The Wiimote.
How do they say that? Wiimote. Woo 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 woo. Woo woo. Wee wee.
From one of our favorite movies. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Kung Pao.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, next week we're gonna have a bigger show.
Are we now?
Well, that's the expectation.
What we should have more. Well, what do we want? What do we hope to do next week?
We really do want to get back to the movies.
Yeah, we're gonna movies. We are going to do that for sure.
We got to watch Phantom Menace first.
Even if we don't get to watch suffer. It.
No, we got to watch it.
Someone's out of town this weekend. Who's that? Me or you?
Can I help that?
No, that's why I'm saying it might not be possible to watch Phantom Menace.
Well, we can. Yeah, okay.
All right. You got to realize it's harder to watch Phantom Menace if you're not in town. Okay.
There's three other nights
see,
the week.
Things
but...
like this where my ex-wife would say, "You guys sound like you're married."
Yeah, that's scary.
That's a perfect example.
That's scary.
It's so funny.
One last quick thing I forgot to mention on the E3 coverage. I just checked. Yeah, we haven't heard anything new yet again, there'll probably be more information by the time this is posted.
Right, definitely.
But you'll enjoy listening to us anyway.
Oh, yeah.
And let's see. There's going to be... That thing is going to supposedly be part of or start with Publish 29.
All right, 29.
The Rory thing, which is supposed to be in June.
Okay.
Now we'll see if they get there with that, because that would be a pretty quick cycle.
Yeah, we're already coming up to June, aren't we? Wow.
Yeah. Oh, let's see. It's been over a year since Rage of the Wookiees, and the Starport map in the Starport doesn't work right there still. We already talked about that.
Yeah. On Kashyyyk.
So sad. I know something to cheer you up.
What?
You can go to a couple websites.
What?
Right?
What? Yes.
You say it this time.
What?
Go to our website.
Which one?
www.swgpodcast.com.
Or www.yivvitsandmrbubble.com.
Yeah.
For the forum,
or you can call
for the
us.
Good stuff.
What's our number?
651-314-4357.
Leave a message. We'll try to play some next week.
Yeah, let's do it.
And I think there'll be some news next week, I'm betting.
I hope so.
Betting there'll be some.
Yeah, E3 will be
done.
We
should have the details about that.
It'll be processed. So
Smet'll call and let us know,
too. For sure we're going to salute a movie, even if you don't get to watch, if we don't get to watch the movie together, we're doing Phantom Menace next week. We got to start. We just got it, okay?
Yeah, and a script. All right, let's play some funky music, huh?
Let's bring it.
All right.
Play funky,
everybody's favorite.
Play that funky music, Yivvits.
Everybody likes this,
do,
huh?
Do.
This is the official... Bum. If we had to pick a Star Wars Galaxies song, this would have to be our original.
If Taylor Hicks were to do a song...
He'd do this?
Oh. He did play that funky music, White Boy, 2 weeks ago. So, on the show.
It just...
So, I mean, this would be up his alley. I think you need more instruments.
Oh, yeah. I can give you that. You want more?
I do. Well, let's let this soak in a little bit.
You want to let it build up a little bit, huh?
Huh?
I think we can handle that. It's a good thing you got that new mixer and that power conditioner.
Oh,
though.
Yeah. Maybe.
That really helped out.
Yep. Clean.
What are we going to do this weekend in the game since... since I'm not going to be around.
Oh, I'll have a great time. Oh, dude, we're not having a party Sunday.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry, folks. No party this week.
No party.
I'm not going to be around, so...
No party with Yivvits.
Well, that's true. You certainly can have a party.
Yeah,
I had a party without you once, so...
You did? What?
Well, that one you knew about.
Oh.
But I didn't tell you about the other...
All right. Well, we will not have an official party. If gatherings happen, maybe I'll be there. Maybe not. Maybe we'll just get some hamburger and grill out and sit outside.
If gathering...
Drink my Guinness.
If the gathering shall happen,
yep.
I may be there. Maybe not. I don't know. No. I don't know. I would like to play this weekend. That's kind of sad, isn't it?
Isn't that fun? That's how it works, though. Whenever you... Yeah, right.
Because I haven't been in there much lately, and I really want to get in and do some things. You know, nobody's making, a lot of armor right now.
Okay.
Because there's no need for it.
Except for your furry friends.
Yes. And I've found a lot of armor for other people, for other species, but not a lot for Wookiees.
Well, there you go. There's your market.
Yeah, well...
There are a lot of Wookiees, where I live.
Yeah.
You lived.
Yeah. Well, that's because we're very Wookiee-friendly.
Yeah. We're progressive. And we get government tax breaks.
Oh, really?
Yeah, for your housing.
Oh, what is there? What's wrong with our houses?
Nothing wrong. It's just to encourage diversity in that they are subsidizing Wookiee development.
Okay. Subsidizing Wookiee development.
Yeah, Wookiee parts of towns. Usually by the starport, other side of the starport.
What are you trying to get at?
I'm just saying. Wookiees are their own little thing.
Oh, what is it? An odor thing?
No. It's what it is.
The litter box scare you?
Yeah, the clumps.
Oh, please. Wookiees are very pristine.
Yeah.
What's that? Is that Chris Kyle again?
No.
You gonna get it?
No, Chris Kyle can wait.
Oh, it's probably just to give you some points on your next time he's on the show.
Well, anything else, buddy? This is fun.
I don't think so.
I like these fun ones.
Yeah, it's a good time.
I think
it's a good thing.
It's a good thing.
Martha Stewart.
Martha Stewart on X on Sirius Radio. I can't believe they have the Martha Stewart channel. Ugh, I can't believe you listen to it all the time.
I do not listen to the Martha Stewart channel. I didn't even know that there was one. There is a Martha Stewart channel?
Swear to God. It's not just her. They have, like, home things. But, I mean, how cool is a cooking show on the radio? But, oh, well.
But that is weird.
It's totally weird, but there it is.
Martha, a cooking show on the...
Martha Stewart Home and Garden. It's on a Sirius channel. They got a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
It's where, you know, it's like our podcast. It's like-minded people go there and talk about things they're into.
But it's cooking.
Yeah.
How's Ottawa Salt?
Ottawa Salt? I wasn't able to get into that thing. I tried it. I mean, I couldn't even... By not getting into it, I mean, I couldn't even log in.
I think it's because you're still using Windows 2000.
I'm a noob. Oh.
I mean, come on. Get with it, dude. MrBubble.
I like Windows 2000.
Are you flying a Jedi Starfighter, a ship that's, you know, well past its prime?
No, but operating systems are one thing. I mean,
if you had your way, I know what you'd be using.
Windows 2000 has lower mass than Windows XP. More maneuverable.
I guess it's far more luxurious.
Yeah, yeah.
No, XP is.
No, XP has got the trim of, like, crate and all that stuff, the big behemoth.
Like a wooden crate? Yeah. You know what you're talking about?
No, the, you know, your ship. Your big Wookiee ship.
Well, let's hope they fix that UI. Someday.
Someday. On Sunday. All right. All right, one final.
Thanks
a lot. I'm going to flip to a trivia book randomly, ask you one question.
All right.
This is random, I swear to God. This is whether you're a Star Wars nerd or not. Ready? I'm touching it. Yivvits.
Okay.
How did R2-D2 get free from the swamp monster on Dagobah?
It spit him out.
And the answer, according to Rusty Miller.
Rusty. Hello, Rusty.
Yeah.
Hi,
hello,
my name's
buddy Rusty. Is, what'd you say?
It spit him out.
That is exactly what it says.
Or vomit him.
No. It spit him out. That you think like Rusty. Well done.
I was Rusty.
All right.
Oh, sir. I'll donate any of my gears and pots.
I'll gladly donate them. Alright.
Have a good week. We'll see you next week for all sorts of jibber jabber.
More jibber jabber.
More jibber jabber. Thanks a lot.